The 8th album by Prince is also a very special one because this is not only a regular album, it is also a soundtrack. This is Parade, the 8th album by Prince with The Revolution, and this is also unfortunately the last album with The Revolution, and this is also, like I said, a soundtrack album, so I'm gonna go into that a bit later. But before I do that, this album is requested by Dylan Coren, who wanted me to do the entire Prince discography, so we're gonna do that. I believe we have 3 or 4 more albums to go, or not the entire discography, but from self-titled up until Love Symbol, so late 70s to the early 90s, so there we are, the highlight of Prince's career. But yeah, this is definitely a pretty special album. It goes a bit back to the R&B roots that Prince had, because this album is this album is R&B, jazz, soul, neo, psychedelia, funk, and baroque pop, something like that. So it has a lot of genres to cover, and don't get me wrong, I really really love this this album. Really think it is a great soundtrack album as well. But the main problem I have with this record, I have to say already that it is a soundtrack, and the main thing with a soundtrack is that you need to have a movie with that, and I believe there is a movie made for a Parade. I'm just trying to read if there is I believe the film is named Under the Cherry Moon, which is also a song on the record. But yeah, the main thing with the album is that you need to watch the movie to really enjoy the record. So although I have enjoyed the record, I cannot say that about the movie because I haven't watched it. And this is actually a bit of a reverse thing that Prince is doing here, because he was also doing this on Purple Rain, but the main thing was with that movie is that the album was made first and then there was a movie adaptation because the album was that popular. But this album is made because there was a movie in the making, so that is a bit of the reversed thing there. But yeah, I have to say that I cannot argue about the movie because I haven't watched it, but yeah, we can all agree that the Purple Rain album is far more superior than the movie. I think we can all agree with that. But yeah, this album is really consistent. It is only 40 minutes long. It has, I believe, 12 songs on it. Some of them are really catchy, really great. Mainly on the second side, because on side one we mainly have transitional songs which really work for the movie, for short scene stuff like that, but not for the album, because it is a bit inconsistent on the first part. Tracks like Christopher's Tracy Parade, New Position, I Want to Use, really short. And Venus de Milo, but that is as the album closer, are really short and are a bit the same. They are really slow in pace, really romantic and stuff like that. So it is pretty funny to see how Prince is evolving as an artist, because on his past releases like Dirty Mind and Around the World in a Day Slightly, Purple Rain, 1999, especially if I didn't say that album already, it was mainly about sex. That was the main thing he was talking about, and it was a bit tiring to hear that over and over again. So he has learned from his stories, from what he is saying, that he doesn't need to talk about sex on every album because that gets a bit tiring. So he is mainly talking about here with love, and it is quite a nice change of pace that he's talking about finally something else rather than other than sex. And those are pretty good albums, but yeah, if every album is about that, it gets a bit tiring, I would say. Yeah, definitely highlights of side one are Under the Cherry Moon, the self-titled from the movie, really relaxing, really feels like we're in Paris, in French. Really feels like that when you listen to this track, really relaxing to the ears, really gives it that French feel to it. I can't really explain it because you just have to listen to it for yourself, really relaxing song. Girls and Boys is a bit more sexual driven, but but Prince is also saying that it is more about love, so he is definitely learning on this track. Really a experiencing song for the artist himself, and maybe if you're if you don't know much about sexuality, then maybe you can learn about his experience as well. But I'm not here to judge, so there we are. I'm not here to learn you that, so yeah. Moving on, Life Can Be So Nice is also a pretty relaxing song. This album is mainly R&B, relaxing, sit back, just lay back music about love. So it is a really romantic sphere to it. Life Can Be So Nice, pretty nice song. Just talking about that life can be nice, like the title. It is a good life if you're living your life right and that you should enjoy it. Yeah, good message, good vibes to the song I get. Pretty good song. Yeah, and then we get into the second side, which is also pretty consistent. Or it is way more consistent because side one is mainly transitions, which is a bit bothering me, but there we are. Side two is, or the beginning is Mountains. Pretty relaxing song as well. Actually written by Wendy and Lisa, and I'm not sure who those are. I believe backup singers who directed the movie as well, or maybe co-produced it, maybe something like that. I believe there was a piano in there, piano on Mountains. Pretty relaxing song, really chill as well. It gives you a bit of those vibes that you're actually on the mountains, that you actually can see the mountains, but also can feel the chill, and you can also feel that on this track. I cannot really explain it as well, but really chilling song when you listen to it. It's a great opener for side two. Yeah, then we got the most famous Prince song, maybe arguably of all time, and that is Kiss. Kiss is a iconic Prince song. Everybody knows the song. Everybody knows the main guitar hooks on this track. When I first heard this song, I definitely have heard it before on the radio, stuff like that. Just in general, I've heard the song before because it is numerous. It is a lot in pop culture because it is that love. The main synthesizers on there really work with the drum beats by Prince and the Revolution. Really great drums and all that. Really great keyboard and synthesizer transitions. And just a really catchy tune, man. Really a Prince classic, really love it. Yeah, and then we get the last two songs, Another Lover Hole in Your Head. Another Lover Hole in, yeah, Another Lover Hole in Your Head. I'm gonna pronounce it like that. Pretty stupid title if you would ask me. Pretty good song overall, 4 minutes in length. So the song is pretty consistent. It has a pretty good length. I really like the song. Well, it is not a Kiss part 2, but I mean, can you blame Prince? It is a pretty perfect song, Kiss then. And Another Lover, I'm gonna name it that, is not exactly part 2, but it's still a really great song to follow it up. And sometimes it snows in April. Sometimes It Snows in April is probably the most relaxing and the most chilled song out of them all. Really relaxing song with a lot of beautiful piano on there. And I just really love the song. It is really mellow in tone, really close out the album perfectly, like the ending credits are rolling. So if I would watch the movie Under the Cherry Moon, which is also a album highlight, I think, then the album would be pretty perfect. But for now, I don't have a picture in mind, or maybe I have, but I haven't seen the movie, so there we are. So maybe if the movie is good and this is the soundtrack, well, it is, then maybe it is a 10 for me if I have a movie with it. But without the movie, you never can have a perfect soundtrack because you gotta have the movie with it. But only the album was requested, so I'm still gonna give the album a 8.6. Still thoroughly enjoyed it, really loved it. Yeah, the main problem I have with the album, like I said, is not the length. The length is pretty good, but the main problem I have with that that side one is mainly transitions, mostly songs that are under the 3 minute mark. One song, Girls and Boys, and Under the Cherry Moon were pretty great in my opinion, but besides that, they were all transitions. Yeah, side two is basically perfect in my opinion, but I would like to see more songs like Kiss on this record, but unfortunately it didn't. But well, yeah, you can't create a perfect record, or well, you can, but it is pretty difficult. And Kiss is definitely a highlight in Prince's discography, and it is a classic tune. It is a classic album, but Kiss is an all-time favorite. It is a fan favorite, but you already probably knew that. I hope you've enjoyed this album review. Let me know what you think about the Prince's Parade album. I thought it was pretty good. Requested by Dylan Coren, if I didn't say that already. I hope you've enjoyed it. Let me know what you think about Parade in the comments down below. And I will speak to you soon. Enjoy.